2013. That is the most bot sounding name I've ever heard. So what has that person, what has this bot won? Let's have a look. Please show the stream if you can. So congratulations to you, Robot SP, whatever it is. You've won a Glock Fade. These are like, I don't know, like almost £300 at the moment. It's crazy.
I had one a
You had
long
one?
time ago. Yeah.
Really?
Had one long time ago.
And what happened?
Let's not delve into that.
All right, so I suppose the other giveaway is for the StatTrak Falchion Knife Fade, so we can see who, well, we need to pick a winner for that one. Mr. Producer Reese, he is going to tell us who won it later, because the pistol has indeed gone live. So if you're waiting to see if you've won that, get wrecked. Envy moving into the A bomb site now pretty quickly, and Kirishima's going to hold things down, taking down his ex-teammate NBK. Trades coming in for both teams, man advantage for the CTs as Envy move onto the site. Bomb's looking to get planted while Kenny covers. Kenny covers well. Devil getting two frags with the assist of Kenny S, giving the T's a man advantage. Bomb down now. Pressure is on the CTs.
Yes, it is. All right, yes. Okay, then. AT is dead.
That's
a great
Why do we pay you? What the hell's that? Anyway, Envy won a pistol round.
Congrats.
Congratulations. Producer Reese, who won the other thing? Come on.
The other winner is Achievo.
Achievo.
Okay, you won a Star Trek Falchion Knife Fade, which you may or may not be shown at some point during the broadcast. For now, we have FaZe on the fourth buy. Ouch! I do wonder, like, if Kirishima just got shot in the face by the person who replaced him in the team, like, how does he feel about that? Does that tilt him? Is he tilted right now?
I don't think he feels anything, James.
Is he angry?
He's numb. He's just pure apathy.
The idea of this team is a bit crazy now, if you think about it. Like, you know, there was a bit of animosity with Makalele and NIP when Makalele made this team and he really wanted to kick their ass, and then it was him, he who got kicked from the team that he created. So, or I suppose they made a mutual decision.
Did they ever get to play NIP in the end? Like in the big tournament? I don't know that they did.
I don't.
Because that was like one of the storylines, wasn't it? Like, Roy's.
I want to say that it almost happened in.
I don't know, mate.
I do not remember.
Either way. We have a pretty good round here. You thought I wasn't going to say anything.
What is going on?
James looked at me. I'm basically just massively tilting James with my new casting style. It's a new casting style, James. Not a fan.
No.
Just very, very random pauses.
Yesterday, you were trolling me when I was trying to leave pauses. Yeah, because they were longer than your pauses.
Your pauses were insanely long. So I wondered if you were actually alive or if you'd.
And now you're. I don't even know what's going on.
Yeah, it's not working out. I think I'm going to have to scrap this and go back to drawing board with it. But yeah, it's cool to see you again, once again, from a good anti-eco there from Envious, anti-force buy type strategy to be able to defeat FaZe in the second round. And it looks like we're going to get to see this lovely knife.
Doesn't so this is what nice. Thingy Bobby won. Achievo.
Congratulations, Achievo. That is a very, very nice.
It's all right, isn't it? It's not bad.
In-game item.
See if you can get yourself 5,000 knife kills.
Without... Oh, yeah, stat trick and everything. Wow.
Yeah.
That is impressive. Well.
So FaZe lost a round, but they ended up surviving with more players than Envy did. So they've got themselves a few weapons out of that. You can see Happy's Mac-10 is in play onto Jacob, and Kirishima is rocking an MP7 at present, but no armor.
Oh, we've got anti-force buys, James. We've got anti-force buy rounds. How good is this?
I feel like
this is a dream.
I feel like Kirishima should have a pistol in this situation, and he should give the MP7 to somebody who has armor, because the aim punch, I think, makes more sense for him to try and play close quarters with a 5.7 and try and get one taps rather than try and spray someone down with the MP7. But there we go.
All right. So the early phase from Envious has passed. I wasn't trying to even do that, but now you've drawn attention to it. You're making us all sound like idiots. But it's passed. And we'll see the rotating player who was kind of lurking towards the A side of the map, catching aggression, moving towards the B site with the push. And as they jump into the B site, it will all be cleared out. as the coordination is strong from the T side. Envious again showing that they have some good anti-force players. And you would expect that as well on this map. This, again, this is one of the maps where Envious are better on. And one of the reasons is because, you know, a player like Kenny S can really get going with the AWP. If things are going well for the team, if the money's going well, if they're not down loads of rounds and they can play without too much pressure, Kenny S can do Kenny S things. And that's wonderful to see. It's hard, very, very hard to trade against him when he's got that AWP. We are going to see just the ending of the round, the formality. And wow, I mean, FaZe...
In the face.
Like as you mentioned, they were able to, you know, keep so much Kevlar and so many pistols into the next round, but they didn't even get a single frag out of it. That's kind of crazy. That's very well done from Envious, to be honest. And that's a 3-0 scoreline for them. And FaZe up with their first buy.
Yeah, and they will be buying down to an inch of their economy. Will the FaZe team... You can see there's nothing left in the bank for them. So again, if they're broken here, then it could be two super bad starts on two maps in this best of three. So Envy moving really fast. They want to break this economy immediately. Although they don't really have an execute in terms of nades, and that will cost them. The tree position proving very strong. Happy alone versus three. So even if three plays survivor for FaZe, that's not bad. I'll take that. Double P coming in from the CTs, and they will be successful. We'll see how many AKs they can pick up, if any. Just the one.
But this is like, you know, because Envious had such clean rounds previously. That's you know, one of those rounds that you're quite happy to lose. Because, as you mentioned, I think the most money a FaZe player had after their buy last round was $100. And you can see now, FaZe are spending everything to get their buy back. So if Envious are able to crush this round, that is going to be very, very frustrating for FaZe. And they're going to go with a set piece, it would seem, on the B-bomb site.
Even when people go for a fast play towards B, I think it's worth just at least having a Molotov onto the tree position, because when you're rushing, it's going to be really hard to spot if somebody's there or not half the time.
It is super dangerous, yeah.
Yeah, so if you just force somebody from that position, which again, AZ is standing on, and they haven't seen him, the boost coming on the other side, but he's seen it already, and down goes Apex. AZ still alive, repositions, looks to find another frag. Over to the water site, teammates running distraction. Kiyoshima taking two down, leaving it into a 4-2. The bomb is down as well.
He's got the plant pot peak. The plant pot peak. And that's...
The triple P down.
Indeed, from AZ. I think, yeah, it was AZ that was down. Is he still there? AZ, yeah, he's still lurking around the statue. Just crouching around. Just showing the headshots. The heads, rather, only. Playing the headshots. And it's going to be... Now MBK in with the AWP, the last hope here in this round for Envious. At the very least, he needs to get an extra frag here, because I think that they still, even without a bomb plant, I think they can still buy actually next round, because I think at least that's possible. And they might want to do it even if they can't necessarily, because the money for FaZe is going to be really awful. So we might see like a set piece with Tech-9s or something like that. But MBK just needs to get an extra frag here. Okay, yeah, they would be able to do a tech line set piece, but otherwise they're probably going to save. What do they go for? That's the question. But still, MBK is alive in this round, but 9 HP is nothing to shout about. He's very exposed at this point, and he will run to his death. Doesn't want to be caught after the time. And do they go for it? I'm not even sure if they realize how poor FaZe's economy is, but looks like they will save run round and have a really good buy in the next. Oh no, they will, or what's going on, James?
What is going on indeed?
They've done a bit of a quasi-buy, but they didn't even have much money to begin with.
And actually, so two players, MBK went for late force as well.
Yeah, two players actually forced up completely. So this money was all over the place. So they are actually doing that kind of set piece towards B, which I initially thought that they would.
It was interesting, MBK left as much money in the bank initially as Kenny did. And I thought, are they going double warp again, but he has gone for the late buy, so it seems we might see him warping more often, generally speaking. Meanwhile, we have the Envy side trying to push towards B. The bomb has been lost in a duel with Kenny S. Two plays on the site, perhaps they could have got the plant there, but it's not going to be the case. The only plants they would get is plant pots in the face. No rhyme intended. Happy last man standing though. He's got the M4, full armor, and pretty much full HP, so he has a world of opportunity afforded to him. You have to wonder, what is the ultimate decision of FaZe here? Will they both continue to stack one site, or will they split up one to each site?
I think I actually like what they're doing. I think this is a better way to do it, because here, you know, they always can attack as two, and they can always try to, ensure that they can get a trade, and they can allow Happy to plant the bomb. I think that's okay. And if, obviously, if he goes B, they're probably going to get the kill before he plants the bomb. So I think this is actually the optimal play from FaZe.
Yeah, I agree. I think sticking together is definitely preferable in this situation. So the bomb has been planted. That Molotov will confirm exactly where it is, because it doesn't seem like they initially realized or could hear the bomb. But now they know it's A. Now, what is the approach? Going to move together, Fox with the pistol in his hand, and Jaken will be the trade man. I like that order, actually, all things considered. So Fox going for the fake. No answer from Happy just yet. Now the Fox is split, and Jaken will almost get taken down in isolation. Happy able to dance around, a Tech 9 coming out, and almost! Jaken, 13 HP. The round is phases, but the damage is done.
The crazy thing is how Happy, I think like 9 times out of 10, probably wins that round with that setup. Like, that first frag seemed guaranteed. He was able to shoot about 10 bullets into that guy before realizing, okay, I need to duck back behind cover. That's crazy that he didn't get that first kill. That would have been the round there, essentially, you know, because he obviously won the second frag. So interesting. And you can see that Envious have a 4x. And with all that damage that Happy just did to the economy of FaZe, they're still against the ropes right now. This is not getting better for them. They are winning rounds, though, at the very least. But that said, you know, we've seen the situation many times where a team will have the other team on the ropes economically almost the entire game, but they never win that one round that they need to win. They get close all the time, but they never actually convert to get the 4C eco out and take control of the map. But a long take going in here from Envious, and this is that sneaky kind of one-time usage sort of position from JKM. Very nice with the silencer, I must say.
I don't know if that smoke is beneficial to him, because it looks like Kenny would probably have the advantage if he walked behind that smoke over Jaken. Doesn't seem like he's willing to engage the angle, however.
It's also one of those things where by it removes his focus from anything but maybe like the top plane, which is actually obviously where he's where Jaken's playing as he's boosted up. But anyway, we have AC with the first frag on to MBK, Happy looking to get a one-on-one and get a good engagement. But he's going to lose a teammate here, and he's going to get challenged by Kiyoshima. And now the push comes in. We get trade frags thanks to Apex and Devil going off towards A. They're actually potentially saving this round right now. And I'm not sure who's calling the pause for free sign there, but we'll have to see after this 2v2 plays out. Obviously, this should be quite favorable for the Ts, but now that Apex has gone down, things get pretty awkward for Devil. He's going to have to get this 4K to win this round. So here comes AZ, first man, he's going to spot him and just nail him down. Okay, not much doing there then from Devil in that position. Not the easiest position, 1v2, to be honest. You only get that one opportunity to win that first battle, and then it gets very difficult, especially with a position like that. So looks like FaZe might finally kind of be in a position to perhaps gain some control of the map, but because there was another bomb down, and I think that's the fourth...
And welcome back. So Fox has returned and we have resumed one round ahead of FaZe at the moment on the CT side of Cobblestone. If you are just joining us, Envy are a map up, winning Dust 2 in convincing fashion. So Envy have gone for a pistol buy. Not sure how much money they have left in the hole, I think.
They had 3,700, I think. So yeah, they're going this quasi. So it should be under 2,000, I guess. Will they do something with it, James? Looks like they are. They are doing things. Things are being done. Things that FaZe do not enjoy. And here comes out the USP, and it works this time. So we saw, obviously, Envious trying this kind of pressure game again and again and again. And you can see their money is super good because they did buy down to about $2,000, got the 3,500 bonus, and life is good. And FaZe have finally been reset. They've won 4 rounds in a row, but every single time Envious were keeping them very, very low on the cash. And you can see the result of this. Jacob has actually bought Kevlar, interestingly. Gone for some Kevlar. I guess he was a bit richer than his teammates. And Apex, if he gets flashed in here, that'd be pretty nice. Or he's going to flash himself in. Who needs teammates? Okay, flash for danger. Apex rather has the flash for the archway here, and he's going to get the first engagement. Oh, and Jaken with that Kevlar, it turns out that the Kevlar was a good investment because he's able to get a kill out of it, but The rest of his teammates are slowly but surely feeling the fury, the French fury.
Devil has 167,000 kills on his AK, so that is insane.
How many?
167,000. Might be more than Scream. Kishima is putting in work for his team here. Kenny's only got 5 HP. He's going to go down, leaving NBK alone. One versus one, and NBK can always rely on him to get the headshots for his team. He is a headshot machine, and there is yet another headshot. So Envy take the lead now over FaZe, who are going to go for the force buy. They have next to no grenades, rain down to the mag 7.
Well, FaZe had almost no investment in the last round. How did they kill so many dudes? They're good at slaying dudes, I suppose. Dude Slayer. Well, the mag 7, James, I know it's a favorite of yours. It's in the hands of none other than the indestructible Rain. How do you feel about this?
I do like me some mag 7. Where is Rain playing with it, though?
He's playing drop,
okay. I think the more common spot has actually become close plateau, and it's so effective from there. It's a huge problem, which perhaps will be solved with nades in the future, Molotovs more specifically. But for now, it is causing absolute havoc over towards B. Rain playing the drop, which in some games you just see it abandoned. He's playing outside of it. Kishima is dead. Jaken is in a position where he could perhaps try and stop this push from coming in, but he does have somebody on his behind. Nice shoulder peek from Jaken, and Kenyas will miss the shot. There's Mag 7 coming into play there. Three jumps, and the third one will be the fatal blow. But Raiden is now alone, and they know he is far, far away.
Yeah, and you can see absolutely what Yanko mentioned that we saw on Dust 2 all the time is we've been seeing it here as well. Multiple rounds now. The default of Envy, I mean, this is like a basic, it seems like a default that they enjoy at the moment that they're trying out, where they send MVK and Happy to harass Plateau and the rest of the teammates go towards A. But Rain is in a 1v2, and it is Rain. He does not have a kit, though, so that's really the issue. There likely isn't going to be enough time for him to actually do the job right now. And he is going to get shut down by Kenny, yes, with the AWP. So Kenny on the AWP is good to see finally. Hopefully we get to see some cool actions from him. But once again, FaZe are set into a spot where they have to go for the eco. And we are going to see a few nades and some Kevlar and a CZ out of Rain. But other than that, nothing really to shout about. And I wonder if Envious will have a more effective anti-eco this time around. Because the last time, they lost four players going towards the A bomb site. So will they stick to the old fateful in the B plats pushes, or are they going to just go for another default? Looks like they're going for that happy NBK combo towards B site again. And leaving the rest of the teammates playing passively towards A. I mean, the cool thing about this is the simplicity, because if they get kills, then obviously they know how to read the round and they can go and reinforce the push and go to B. They fail or get one kill, there's rotation, then the teammates can go with the bomb to the other site. It's very simple decision making, and so far so good, although it's 1v1. They still need to get onto the bomb site, and Rain's going to go close to the CZ. Very dangerous business, but he's going to get shut down as well. So looks pretty good here for Envious. Fox now the big issue, but has no Kevlar.
The bomb!
Oh no. Anu.
Peter 50 putting in more work, and this is dangerous waters now for the NV side. So what is the play? Fox could be anywhere now. They are going to be guessing all the way wherever they may go. Just holding angles for now, but 40 seconds left on the clock. They can't hold formation for long. Seems Fox is going to bank on the B-bomb site. Envy, what is the play here? What is the play? It seems they are headed towards connector at the very least, but 20 seconds now. By the time they make it to the site, it may be a desperate dash to push to a plant the bomb, excuse me.
I was about to say, it's very strange how split up they are. Why are they so split up? There's no way that Apex can trade. Oh no, he's got to get the kill. Obviously, he knows where the player is, so. Oh no, the blind spot! He completely. And now he doesn't have time to even plant! Oh, James, this is a mess. Oh, at least he gets the kill and doesn't die after time, but what a mess right there. Again, Envious cannot win against these force buys on Cobblestone. It's not nearly as strong as their anti-force buys on Dust 2. Oh dear, that's the second round that FaZe have of one like that in that kind of way, that is devastating. It's very hard to witness as well.
Yeah, that was a brutal one.
But I do wonder why they're so spread apart. What if he's, you know, he was playing Platin, you know, the bomb goes down there. There's so many ways for it to fail, basically. But anyway, Envious 6-5. I'm sure Yanko we can dig into that one later. I cannot wait. Get the Yanko on it. And well, it looks like the pistols are going to be doing quite well for Envious as well. The pistols, the Kevlar, the fast round into B will deliver the kills that they need to take the bomb plants. And three frags unreturned. So that is a lot of weaponry that they can pick up. Trying to push down the CTs, of which only JKM is now the remainder. And we're going to see whether or not he can stay alive here. Hopefully, Envious don't get overzealous. Because FaZe just won a round, it's not the end of the world that they allowed JKM to save and not lose any economy themselves. Not the end of the world. But they are trying to hunt him down.
This is quite the back and forth, isn't it? Quite the back and forth indeed. Boom, almost in unison with the bomb explosion there. Envy take another round.
Look at that cash though.
What cash, Dan?
Exactly.
I don't see much cash.
Look at the cash. They're gonna have to be looking down the, like upturning the sofa cushions and looking under their beds for some more change.
Selling the family china. The colour TV, Dan.
It's gone.
Selling the colour TV.
HD, how about single definition? Or whatever the hell the SD stands for. I actually don't know what SD stands for.
Standard definition?
I guess yeah. I don't know why it's a single.
Single definition.
I don't know why that's the first thing.
As opposed to double definition, Dan.
I am definitely a complete idiot.
What year was triple definition released?
I could do some quadruple definition. Well, again, it's back to the anti-eco type play, but we're seeing that the default comes in from Envious again, where MBK and Happy try to take 1v1s on B plateau, and the bomb just sits towards A, hoping for perhaps a rotation to capitalize upon or some early aggression. And this, Jay came in from the back. And that is the problem here. And now weapons will be picked up. They can toss the AKs to each other. They've got Kiyoshima looking for an AK of his own. And he's going to find an M4 rather. And Apex is going to... Is he alone? He's alone. He's going to flash in. He's going to... Oh, get the spray down there on Kiyoshima as he turns the corner very quickly. JKM getting the refrag though. And once again, a bit of a mess of an anti-eco because this was not really an anti-eco from Envious. They just played their default round against that they would play against Guns. And it doesn't seem to be tooled correctly for this purpose. And we are going to see enough time here for Kenny S to potentially clutch this round, but there are two CTs standing to attention, awaiting his plant. They're doing a good job at moving around, but not peeking him directly. Ooh, but as I say that, Kenny S is going to find JKM and gets the conversion kill onto Fox as well. Nice. Tech 9 is going to be helping them out. 8-5. Kenny S saves them, saves their bacon. But really, why are they... This is a systemic issue with how they are playing their cobble. That they are being taken to the brink every anti-eco.
Well, fortunately for them, there are a mere two rounds left in this first half. Although this one is another eco here from FaZe. And it seems it's going to be a fast play towards the A site from Envy. Again, I really want to see a Molotov towards the tree when teams play this strat, because it just makes life that little bit easier for them. So Pop Flash comes in and the charge will begin from Envy. Is anybody looking for the player at the back? That's AZ. AZ goes down. So far, so good for Envy. Still two CTs to be found around this site. Fox gets some nice damage in, but he will be taken down, as will Kiyoshima, leaving Rain alone versus three. And he's currently in T spawn, no less. Gonna be going past the Portapuis.
Nice.
So we'll see if he can pick up a gun. But other than that, we're looking at 9-6. There's no kit, there's no ninja defuse happening in this particular round.
And this time, you know, they actually decided to do a round that bears more semblance to an actual, strategy that's going to be good against a team that's saving. And they get themselves into B without too much issue, and losing two players this time, sort of almost a round. Just Kenny has something to clutch against two. And Rain trying to force bit of havoc there, but he will go down in the end. And we shall have that 9-5. And FaZe, they will get their buy-in. Now, curious whether we'll just see the straight-up default from Envious again. MBK and Happy pressuring towards B, and the rest of the team just kind of waiting towards A. That's basically been their, so many of their, I mean, it's very possible that they're testing this stuff out, but, you know, a team like Envious, you would expect them to have stuff they're testing out, that they do that in practice and not in official matches. So, well, this is once. Ooh, MBK, he's going to sneak in. He's going full solid Snake James, but the snake is dead.
I wanted to make some kind of liquid snake reference, but it just didn't work out for me, mate. I don't know the lore that much. So the FaZe team are trying to hold on. Our flashes will stop Jacob from surviving, however, down to 3v3. The bomb is on the floor at the moment. Fox closed, but Apex will be the one to take him down. He will get caught on the reload, and obviously it is Rain, who else, who is clutching it for his team at the moment, putting Happy in a very disadvantageous situation. Did he just get spotted there? He must have come up on the radar. He's only got 12 HP, so it's not going to be easy. It's going to be a lot of ducking and diving going on to allow this to work out. I think he realizes where both players are now, and he can use the APC to try and get himself a 1v1, but he might have to guess as to where Rain is behind that structure. Found, but not killed. FaZe take the last round of the first half.
May I just say, James, that Rain is incredibly good at Counter-Strike.
Rain is very good at Counter-Strike.
He is very good. I wouldn't say that he's underrated. I just feel like I always want to see more of him, and we just don't get to see enough of Rain. Because FaZe are on a slump since the major. Well, two majors ago now, since Cluj, I suppose.
So the winner of the Karambit Rust Coat was E-Rain Testox.
E-Rain Testox.
These are just random names. E-Rain Testox. You won the knife.
Congrats.
So, indeed, congrats. We will send you...
We will knife you soon.
Yeah, we'll do that, basically. So, Envy's chance on the CT side. What do you think of six rounds on a CT side for FaZe?
I think that is more than acceptable. I think that's totally fine. I think that's good. Pretty comfortable. This is a map of T sides, I would say, generally speaking. And but the thing is that FaZe, you know, you need good coordination, and you need obviously some drills. And this is something that, you know, FaZe need to show us that they are going to be strong with, because we know that they have clutch potential. They got Rain, they have sick individual players, and right now Akinius is trying to save the round, trying to save Envious's early round economy, but it's not going to happen. It looks like Apex against four players. AZ is already on the flank as well. So should Apex get fortunate, get through the smoke somehow, maybe pick up a kill, by the time all that's happened, AZ's going to be in the back with the frag, and he's already potentially in position for this. Now, Apex might hear his running, though. And there it is. He will hear the running, but he can't win the frag. So 9-7. FaZe will start off with a good economy. Now, would like to see Envious skip the full force buy, to be honest. Not going to happen, though. It is Envious, James. But I feel like it's very hard. I mean, like, for example, let's look at it this way. You got arguably one of the best AWPers in the world, Kenny S. AWPing on this map is very strong on the CT side. Kenny S is now forced. He cannot afford an AWP on the fourth round of the second half. He cannot do that now. Or if he can, if he gets some kills and so on, he's going to have no Kevlar with it. So he's going to have limited options with no nades as well.
Oh, dear. FaZe better move quickly over towards the A bomb site, because they've lost an AK and Envy on the force, which means there is armor behind that AK. And they've only got one AK on the rest of the team. And the SMG is pissed on Kiyoshima, no. So this could easily fall apart for FaZe. We could see more force buys winning than two-man advantage now. Not a one-man, but a two-man advantage for FaZe. For Envy over FaZe. And that's it. It's Jacob versus basically the entire Envy side.
Yeah, he can't plant. There's no way he can plant here. He's got to kill them. And oh my god. That was quite funny, I've got to say. Like, just basically rushing everyone up around drop and B plateau in towards the Dragon Lord Tapestry, just rotating all the way around, just picking up kills as they go. They're just like a monster truck of death rolling through the map. And I mean, again, you know, you don't want to be results oriented. Obviously, that round went really well for them, but I think most of the time they're not going to win that round. And Kenyus is not going to be on AWP early. And I think that you're going to need that. Oh, a bit of taste of your own medicine. A AZ in with two frags from the Tech Nine. FaZe showing that they are made of strong stuff with the pistols as well. And it's going to be a 3-4 in favor of the FaZe side. But Apex is coming in from the behind. I wonder if they've spotted him. I'm not sure if they have or not. And it looks like they hadn't, but here he goes. Can he get anything done here? Lots of damage being made by Apex. Can't escape in time. But you'd like to think that he's done enough damage. But again, the Tech Nine man, how is it doing this? The long range headshots. And Jake can survive a 4 HP against Devil. Now, do you believe, James? Do you believe in Jake with 4 HP and a Tech 9?
Anything's possible. He should get the bomb plant here. So if he plays to the advantages of his gun, then this could go either way. It may be a case of first hit wins, basically. So let's see. If he's going to go for that plant, I feel like he could plant around the corner and make it even more exposed. It is a bit more of a risk, but then he can basically defend the bomb from almost anywhere. So again, he is playing close quarters and he can use the APC if he hears Devil running around, which he should. So Jacob has lots of advantages here and it's going to be hard for Devil to discern his position. So Jacob should come out on top. He can move closer to the APC now that he hears Devil, and indeed he will do exactly that. So very simple stuff, very hard to deal with. Devil has a kit, but I don't know if he has enough time to even defuse the bomb at this point.
The first bullet indeed, but there was no time. He did have a kit, but there's no time. And good clutch there coming out from JKM. Very much needed for FaZe, and Envy is probably going to force buyback just because it's Envy, who knows. I mean, they need to save once, and you can see Kenny S is actually going to spend quite a bit of money. And he should still be able to get an AWP next round, I think. How many have they lost in a row now? Two?
Envy's? No, they won a previous, didn't they? They won the previous one.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
Get $5,000. He will have $5,000 if they lose this round.
Okay, so you can get AWP no armor.
Yeah.
That's
interesting.
Okay, well, again, FaZe have to play good anti-ecos as well. And Envious have stacked towards the A site, so if FaZe try to kind of half-ass their way in towards the A side of the map, then they are going to be at the mercy of the pistols, but it doesn't look like they are going to do that. That said, they are playing really passively right now, so it's unclear as to which way they do actually want to commit themselves. B Plateau is very, again, I don't want to say ever that anything is particularly foolproof in high-level Counter-Strike, but one of the more foolproof options is going to be the B Plat as your anti-eco. Easy to trade, easy to stick together, good vantage points. You can split out onto the site very quickly, and it's more comfortable, I'd say, than some options. But you need to those nades to clear out those very, very close positions that James was talking about that people like to occupy with the Mag 7. That's very dangerous. And indeed, they go towards B. And Envious just really committing to this A hold. And the thing is that they can buy next round. So it's actually fine for them to just go for it right now and just try to get some kills onto FaZe. Otherwise, if they weren't buying next round, you'd say, okay, just save the pistols right now. But
at this point, I think...
Maybe with Kenny. Like, Kenny, you can make an argument for Kenny to save.
Yeah, I don't think there's no point really. Then there's no point in trying to retake the site. That's for sure.
And play exit.
I think they can move around the kind of exit points, but yeah, I was gonna say three kills for AZ, but not really. And another AK has been dropped.
That's nice
for the CT. So at this point, take that and save. We've got one player playing around the large pillar here, which is going to be happy with a 5-7. So far, so good. Fox getting taken down. There is a trade, however, but more CTs now are going for it. Kenny S is going to be the man saving the AK. So it's smart. Kenny can buy the AWP and drop the AK in the next round.
Yep.
And it's all worked out for him.
And drop the Deagle.
Respect.
Well, if he wants to.
Yeah.
I guess as the AWP, he's probably going to want to keep the Deagle. Good old Deagles. I've had so many good times with Deagles over the many, many years and iterations of the Counter-Strikes.
Good times with the Deagle.
Yeah. There was this Deagle map he's playing 1.6. What was it called? Like CS Deagle 5 or something. I can't remember what it's called exactly, but I spent a lot of time on that map. Anyway.
Scouts and Knives, mate.
Used to play a lot of that as well in 1.6. Low gravity. But here you go. Quick push in from the FaZe side. And it's, wow, the kills. How many kills in the space of a single second there? So many frags. all over the place. Hard to
say anything.
How to figure out where we're at afterwards, but the bomb will be planted by FaZe. So awful situation because Kenny can have no impact in the defense, in the initial defensive efforts. But here he comes with his magic stick and no fast frag, so they're going to go back and save. Smart. Very smart indeed. That's the thing with the set piece on the B-bomb site. It's just difficult. Sometimes it can work, you know, 5 out of 5 times. Sometimes it's going to work like 1 out of 5 times. You just don't know. But it's the chaos really that can be very, very good. It can help you also beat a team that's probably better than you, because you'll eventually get rounds like that. Or you can always get rounds like that, I would say. And there you're going to tie the thing up. The thing is good. It's tied, James. 10 to 10.
They've tied the thing, Dan. That's good to know.
The thing is tied.
The thing is indeed tied. It's safely secured. It's tied. So the money is poor for the Envy side. What will they choose to do around this AWP and M4? It seems the buy will be minimal. But I do wonder what the level of aggression should be higher than normal for these weapons. Moving 4 players over towards the B-bomb site, will there be an early peek over towards the plateau? Well, yeah, this is the position where Kenny should be getting boosted. Indeed, he will be. So I think we saw it yesterday. Senfis was trying to jump up where those flames were, obviously with the smoke down. But Kenya's doing it the much safer way. And there we go. Good start from him. Can he escape though? Looking for another frag. Not able to get it. But the AWP is retrievable by the Envy side. Devil would be taking a bit of a risk to get it at this point. Is he in the smoke? I think he is, but it hasn't worked out for the team. So perhaps picking up the AWP may have been better. NBK unlucky not to get that, but Apex has come in to get the frag for his team. Man advantage for FaZe. Envy still only have the one rifle into NBK. So trying to pop out and get another frag, and indeed he'll do it this time. The P250 coming out. AZ gets blinded as well. But down to 1v1, and NBK can't get his sight back in time. Ex-teammate Kiyoshima takes the round for FaZe. Envy lose the lead.
But they have a full buy right now, so that's not the most terrible thing in the world. Kenny's still on an AWP. So this is the cool thing, right? Is that Kenny's gets... Oh, was he just shy of enough for Kevlar? No.
He had 54-50.
Yeah, no,
if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah, because it's cool that he opted to get nades over Kevlar. I think that's actually smart as an AWPer. Because if you're playing, you know, you can very much tailor the angles that you play, and you can see, look at this, it's incredibly long. If he's not going to get tagged here...
Look at this.
You don't really need the Kevlar so much if you're playing the really long angles. And the nades are much more important. So pretty smart by Kenny, I'd say. And Rain going to be pop-flashing himself deep onto the B-plateau, getting his Olafmeister on, getting his Nico on. And so far, he will be able to pick up a frag. NBK is going to fall victim to Rain, the Bond villain Rain.
Early advantage for FaZe. And as you can see, things have slowed down. Most of their team are over towards the A-bomb site, so Rain's going to be shoulder-peeking the choke point, and he'll be punished for doing so. Things get tied up, and FaZe start to move back towards the A-bomb site. AZ's noise will raise a warning sign to the Envy side, who are going to have two people rotating into A now, but maybe they're going to have the entire team there, as it seems that FaZe are committed. AZ goes down to Kenny S. He's on the site now. Fox gets taken out as well. Two more to find for Kenny S. He's got 2 plays in for support, but he might not need them. Down goes Jacob. Can Kiyoshima get finished off? Of course he can. Kenny was a 4-man on the A site and an ace overall. Absolutely monstrous stuff from the Frenchman.
Yeah, man. The crazy thing is that when they were pushing from A long, he got a penetration tag on somebody as well.
Nice.
And he didn't obviously need it because he just wrecked everyone anyway. When Kenny starts like getting into that mode where he starts just flicking her all over the place, that is so scary. Lovely to see. And this is what we're talking about. This is why you want that AWP on Kenny S, man. And remember, he didn't buy Kevlar in that round. He didn't need it to waste them.
He had no Kevlar ace then.
He did not need it to waste them.
That is nuts.
Did not need it to waste them because he's Kenny S. And he's got the AWP. And MBK, can he get the jump shot? Unfortunately for him, he can't get the initial shot, but there he will get a second chance, and he's going to be good on that second chance. Maybe even more chances right now, and he will get the dink onto AZ, but AZ will find the finish eventually onto MBK, removing him as pesky as he was. And now it's going to be FaZe putting their efforts towards B plateau. Happy's there. The only thing that's going in their way is that Kenny S is not here at the moment. He's starting to hit some form. And we are going to see Fox and AZ picking up the entry frags right now. And now it's time for the big boys, Apex and Kenyes, to march their way in to find themselves this retake for Envious. And the bomb has yet to be planted, so they are waiting for the T's to make a move, very smartly so. Flash in from Kenyes as Apex creeps around the side. There is the first frag coming in from Apex. Can't make the second one happen. And now it's going to be up to Kenyes. Is he going to be able to pull this one out of the bag? That first flick comes in. Kenyes, you can see, is a little bit frustrated to miss that one. He knows he might not get another or a better chance. He's going to go with the flash. Is he going to hold? Looks like he won't. Oh, he gets the shot so incredibly quick. Is this man? Kenyes is going to find that defuse. Envious go 12 to 11. And it's yet another round where Kenyes is keeping them in it. He's saved them so many times, James. It is beyond count.
Yeah, it's pretty sick stuff. So, man, round advantage for Envy now. An economy is being wrecked by FaZe. The only thing they have in their advantage is that they got the bomb plant down, so they will be able to get some pistols, some armor here and there. But what is their play in such a bad economical state? Do they have something in mind, or are they just going for fixed? They can move in quickly into the drop zone. Fox coming in too late to trade NBK, and he's going to get shot straight in the face by Devil. The lack of helmet will be a nice bonus for him there. We've got the three last T's moving into the B bomb site, but it's going to be easy pickings for the Envy side. 13 to 11, getting close to the 2-0 now.
Absolutely. It's really nice to see that they're actually enabling Kenyes to do his thing, because that's really, really important on this map, especially when it comes to some of these clutch rounds that we're seeing. And for the large part, FaZe have actually been avoiding Kenyes, largely. Maybe they've been mostly going to B, that's where most of their rounds have been won, and Kenyes is forced to go for a retake. It makes his life much harder. But this round might not be any different with Dubai. But this time, they've put Kenyes over towards the B plateau, and he's going to get boosted up right now. And there are a lot of FaZe players here that could be challenging. Three men aggression coming in early for Envious. Nice idea early in the round to maybe counter fast aggression. Now they will be falling back and keeping Kenyes deep on the B plateau, but he is yet to be challenged. When will the first challenge arrive? Do they dare? Do they dare? There's no way that they know that he's there.
Could be a nasty surprise if they eventually head in that direction. But what is the play? Rain is not really over towards the A site. He's just looking for a flank, which would suggest a B play as opposed to a split through connector into A. But it seems they're very scared to peek the angle, knowing that Kenyes could be in position. So 45 seconds left on the clock, and someone's going to have to peek. I think he might have seen a bit of a hand there. So Kenny's going to flash for his teammate, very nicely done, and that's going to be perfect timing for NBK to pop out and try and get some frags. He's going to get two, Jacob and AZ going down. Kenyes repositions, and he's got people to find over towards the B bomb site now. Two frags for him. Can he find a third Kishima? The Tectonine coming in. Two men wiping out the NV side there, the FaZe side. Very nice play, but very good timing for him to get that pop flash in for NBK as well.
Kenyes' flicks are just godlike. Just so godlike, so fast. And it's just, it doesn't matter like how hard the shot is. The flick will find the opponent. Kenyes is the Reaper Man. He's stealing souls. He's taking souls.
The Reaper Man or Repo Man?
The Reaper Man.
Reaper.
Reaper, yeah.
I thought you said Repo, because there was a wrestler called the Repo Man. But I'd be surprised. I would be very shocked if you were making wrestling references then.
No, yeah, well. Well, and also, Repo stands for like repossession, right? Someone coming to repossess all your stuff because
you're not paying them bills.
You haven't been paying the bills yet. But Reaper Man is much cooler. And we're going to see, once again, the push coming in onto the B-bomb site and Envious going in for the defense. I like that FaZe are keeping it simple. And, you know, sometimes that's enough. But Envious, they're one round away from closing this one. And I've got to say, Kenyes, this guy has definitely been on point for his team in this matchup and on Cobblestone. And again, there's so many spots where he saved them. Like, imagine all the anti-ecos, which looked hopeless. Then he comes in and, you know, clutches all these, that ace, for example, all that round just there where he got the three kills defending B plateau all by himself. You know, there's a lot of spots where he's done massive amounts of work here. Otherwise, if he hadn't been doing that, this game would probably be, it could be the other way around the scoreline for FaZe. So big props there. Always good to see him playing well. And now it's Apex in danger with a bit of a pop flash. Oh, the kiss cam. Where's the kiss cam at? And it's going to be Apex. It's still alive in there, 12 HP. He's got a smoke now. And this is awkward. This is highly, highly awkward. Apex still in danger. They must know that he's there. But it looks to be that he will escape with his life and actually get back onto the A site.
Over a minute on the clock for wow, Kenny, please. Saw some spray from Jacob through the door and just shot him through the door. Go away. You are finished, son. Apex is still alive. He has been quite the nuisance for his team. Devil's been taken down elsewhere. There is just the one lurker in range towards the B bombsite, and he is reasonably advanced with not much aggression from the CTs at the moment, so that might be why there's a rotation coming in from the Ts, but he hasn't made any significant advances onto the site itself. And Envy seeing A start to get quiet and moving back towards B, so it might be opportunity loss rather than opportunity knocks here for the T side. Rain gets taken out by the bot by the HE as well, so it's all falling apart for phase 2 versus 2. Still a chance for them. Fox on the platform getting flashed by Happy's teammate Apex. It will slow things down. Kiyoshima to plant the bomb now.
Yeah, this round, Kenny is not landing some of those ridiculous shots. At least not all of them. He did get two frags, that is. But looks like it's down to Happy and Apex. And so far, it's working out for them. Fox is dead. And Happy will be rewarded the frag and the defuse. And that's Envious with the match. The best of three will be won by them. And I would say somewhat convincingly so, especially, you know, if you look at how Dust 2 went. It was very dominating. A dominating beginning for them and Cobblestone. To be honest, that said, Cobblestone probably, if Kenny S wasn't hitting those crazy shots on all those rounds and saving them in those clutch situations, this could have been phases, actually.
Yanko, how did you feel about that tournament? Match!
God damn.
I think it was interesting from what we mentioned during the break, that it was obvious that NVS is trying to, you know, maybe use Happy and NBK as a pair of sorts, and then the other team is waiting on the other side of the map. But besides that, you could see at times why, I mean, the reason why FaZe vetoes this map a lot, they don't play it that often. There was a particular situation that when Kyo was on B platform in that corner, he had a teammate on top of the tree on block. And he was, you know, counter-flashing, but he ended up flashing his teammate. And then the Envious player, who was the first one in the entry fragger, managed to get the kill. And in the end, FaZe lose that round. So you could see that at times their coordination is off. They're not really aware of each other's positions, so to speak. And then on the other half, well, they did lose pistol, win the second round. And then at some point, just Kenny S decided to show up and say, you will not win this game.
Yeah, so FaZe's run came to the end of the line at the hands of Kenny S. And that is going to bring our European broadcast to a close. Just the one European match today. So in about 5 hours' time, we will be back with the North American segment. Two matches coming your way there. So thank you for tuning in. And we will see you at midnight with more CS, this time the North American region.